Okay, so most people know how to take a screenshot using the shortcuts. Or if you don't, on a Mac, it's Command Shift 3 to do the whole damn thing, and Command Shift 4 if you want to just select a certain area, which I'll show you in a second. Windows, it's the logo key, Shift, and S. So those are really handy in day-to-day screenshot life. But one thing that I use even more than that is the awesome screenshot plugin for Chrome. You can find it by going into Google and typing awesome screenshot. Should be option number one, and then click add to Chrome, and it's a browser extension that will then go through the process of asking you if you're happy to install. In my case, it's already there, so it's giving me the option to remove, which I don't want to do. And once you've installed the extension, you can click the little puzzle piece up here and turn things on and off to get them to appear. And then once they're appearing, you can move them around to the order that you want. So this little fancy guy here is the awesome screenshot button. Just to get real meta, if I was to do Command Shift 4 on a Mac, that would give me this normal screenshotting option. Great, handy, that'll go to my desktop. But in this case, why I like Awesome Screenshot is that it lets you do things like capture the full page. So, not just what you can see on the screen, but if you click full page, it'll get everything from the whole site that you're on, which can sometimes be handy if you're not wanting to stitch together multiple images. This is how it works with before it saves the file, it lets you edit it. So, you might have got the whole page and then said, oh, okay, actually, I only want this part of it so I can crop. And then you might want to annotate, you know, this is the part, let's make it 8 and text, look at this. So you can add text, you can highlight stuff, you can blur if you're wanting to not show different parts and highlight the thing that you're on. It basically gives you a pretty powerful little fast editing tool. And then, when you're happy with what's there, you just click done and it gives you the option to download that file. So, I'll download that to my desktop and then I can close the tab. So, it's pretty handy and I use it all the time. The other cool thing that it will do is visible part after delay. So, I might want to show a particular state of the screen that isn't possible when I'm clicking. So, that will let me do something within the screen and it'll capture it while I'm doing that thing. So, for example, if I go into the extension visible part after delay and I want to highlight this thing, it's captured it with that highlight. And that's probably more relevant when you've got something on the screen that changes or that you interact with and you want to capture that particular moment. Very handy. Other things it can do is either just record the visible part of the page or a selected area. So you might off the bat just want this part and I want to capture and it will do it the same as before. And then I'd better give it a different name. And then the next level is doing a recording. So, if you wanted to do a short screen recording, there's an option there, which is a video for another day. It's a great little app, it's free, and you only start to run into issues when you want to use the fancier parts of the tool, which I haven't had to yet, but there may be another video in the future if I ever upgrade. Anyway, it's worth downloading and trying out for yourself. Hope this helps. Bye.